Hello, everyone.
Glad you tuned in. The prophetic word for this month is pneumatic resonance. I'm sure you will be blessed as you join the worship.
Forgive me if I haven't been that which you want me to be, Lord. But help me to be better. Help me to be more like you, Heavenly Father. We're here to worship you, to adore you, to blow kisses to you, because you deserve adoration, praise, and honor, Heavenly Father.
To the following information, and God bless you as you listen and participate to them. The church has two services lined up each and every Sunday. The first service starts from 10 a.m. to 11:30. The second service starts from 12 noon to 1:30. You're welcome to join us with your family and friends. Counseling with Pastor Chris Ereme takes place each and every Wednesday from 4 to 6 p.m. Please register with the church secretary, Sister Deborah Arunu, in advance. Bible study. Grow in the Word with our Bible classes every Wednesday from 7 to 9 p.m. There is also the possibility to join us online. The link will be posted on all our social media platforms. Women's Prayer Meeting. Women's Prayer Meeting holds every Friday from 6 to 7 p.m. For more information, contact the Women's Leader. The Youth of BOCC. The Youth of BOCC meets every Sunday morning from 8 a.m. to 9 a.m. and every second Friday of the month from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. Every youth is free to join and invite their friends too. Moving on to the Prayer Intercessors. The Prayer Intercessors meet every second and third Saturday of the month. Question and answering. There is the opportunity for personal interactions as we tackle problematic issues and provide biblical answers in our Q&A sessions. This takes place every last Sunday of the month. Don't miss out. Night vigil takes place every last Friday of the month from 11 p.m. to the next morning. And Testimony Sunday takes place every third Sunday of the month. And lastly, the venue for all our church activities is the church auditorium. Please visit our website at www.bocc-stuttgart.de. We wish you a fruitful week and stay blessed.
Is there anyone joining us for the very first time this morning? If today is your first time of joining us, just wave at me wherever you're sitting. Anyone at all? All right, everyone has always been around. Praise the Lord. So you have your Bible with you. Let's go by the way of John chapter 19 this morning, verse 24. It's just one verse we are going to look into, and by the special grace of God, I believe that today we'll be able to finish our long series of impact in our world, which took us almost 3 months approximately. Hallelujah. John chapter 19, verse 24. Can we please stand up for the reading of the word of the Lord? Hallelujah. Then said therefore among themselves, let us not rend it, but cast lot for it, whose it shall be, that the scripture might be fulfilled, which saith, departed my garment among them, and for my venture they did cast lots. These things therefore the soldiers did. I take it up again. It says, they said therefore among themselves, let us not rend it, talking about the clothes of Jesus, but cast lot for it, whose it shall be, that the scripture might be fulfilled, which said, departed my raiment among them, and for my vengeance they did cast lots. This is what the soldiers did. Spirit of the living God, have your preeminence in this place. Let your will be done. Let your purpose be established. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Let us sit down in the presence of the Lord. God bless you richly. Hallelujah. On a wonderful afternoon like that, a man went out and put his small little shield outside while he was collecting his arms and begging for arms. The blind man does this each and every afternoon, but this afternoon is going to be a different one. He went out and people will drop a little bit of coins here and there inside small little thing that he has on the side. On this particular afternoon, a woman walked by. She's not very looking very friendly. Walked by and did not drop anything. Grabbed his card or his box or his sign and decided to rewrite whatever was written down on it. And after she finished writing, she left the card with the man and walked away. The blind man noticed that after this kind of funny woman that did not say anything went away, people started dropping a lot of coins. They were blessing him so much. And the man now decided to ask, he says, what did you do to my sign? The woman said, I only changed the words. The word. What will happen if I can just change some words? What can I change in anyone's life today if I can just change small little things? It's being said that it's not the big things that matters, but the small little ones. While I was in going to school and I was in my fifth grade, my maths was very awful, and my senior brother, quite elderly one to me, decided to be teaching me maths since he's extremely good in maths, and he did not understand why I was not getting it. And I was a word person, like you can hear and see, and thank God for that grace. And he is a mathematical individual, and I have no idea how you can just put all those numbers together and make sense. It's quite difficult for me. Some of you, when you went to school, I mean, you still remember, you know, all those things they put together. I mean, it was okay when they were asking us to put figures together, but now when they started to put letters together with figures, who understand what I'm trying to say? Praise the Lord. I don't know how mathematics went that far. When you are putting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it doesn't matter, whatever figure you have is okay. But when you start to put letters, and all of a sudden you are putting before minus, you are putting a plus and a point, and then divided, and then square root, then I just lost my whole mind. I'm like, what is this all about? And they're trying to tell you this is some Pythagoras theory, this is some algebra. I don't really care what they are. The only problem I had in school was, how can you start calculating letters instead of figures? And my brother sat me down and starts to explain some few things to me. All I wanted to know is an explanation. And immediately he was able to explain to me, after a lot of studies, a lot of scolding, a lot of standing awake the whole night, up to 3 to 4 o'clock in the next morning. That was how far we were studying. I don't know about all the children of our days that didn't learn to study so late in the night. We would study till 3 to 4, and I have to wake up by 6 again, and it will not be patient with me. And my senior brother will not actually look into my situation, that I have to go to school the next morning. Is all I'm going to sleep is 2 hours. It goes like that. Your brain is too much of sleep. So let us start to eliminate sleep out of it until it starts to be grabbing it. After 16 hours of studying, he was able to explain to me, and I was able to get it one day. One day I just got it. It just made sense to me. And from that day on, it became a problem that I will be forever able to solve just by giving me a clue of what I need to know. Imagine what you need to know right now if somebody knows how to help you out, just to go from this level to the next level. And we are just going through our struggles and strains and pain and hassles, but don't know that if I could artistically be able to change some few things in my life, in your life will be better than whatever it is right now. My prayer for each and everyone that is sitting down in this place and listen to us over the airwaves is that whatever you need for you to get that little bit of twist that will change your life for the better, may you get to know it in the mighty name of Jesus. I don't know about you, there are many times in my life I ask myself, what am I doing wrong about this particular issue? Who understands what I'm talking about? It's not every issue, it's just one particular one that you ask yourself, what is it that I did wrong? What am I doing wrong continually concerning this issue? And if you can just get the artistic way of turning it around, we might be able to get something out of it. A woman by the name of Francis Schaeffer pointed out in his Francis Schaeffer pointed out in his land book, and that book is How Should I Then Live? How Can I Live? In his book, he says that the coming of Christ Jesus greatly influenced the art, that prior to Christ's birth, music was played in minor chord. All the music that you are hearing right now before the birth of Jesus was not the way it is sounding now. It was very primary. It was very simple. It was only on minor chords they were playing instruments. showing the incompleteness and lack of harmony of life. Before Christ, listen, there was no harmony in life. After Christ's death and resurrection brought the wholeness to the individuals and nation, people began to become creative. After the birth of Christ and after his death and resurrection, the creativity of human race generally all over the world changed. People became more creative. People are very particular in their expressions, how they express their reconciliation back to God. And due to that, for whatever reason, biological science could not be able to dictate to us, people were able to become creative in their mind and in their thoughts. That art is a way whereby God himself expresses his beauty, expresses his emotions, his will, and his mandate. And I'm praying to God in this season that each and every one of you, you will discover your own creativity, your art, in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever is inside of you that needs to come out, it needs to come out in an artistic way which needs to be presentable to the mankind. And I'm praying to God in this season that by the time you start to present it, that man will look to it and embrace it. It will look wonderful in the eyes of man. No one will turn you down, but they will turn you up. I wish I have somebody to say better amen on that. Don't be drunk with wine, but be filled with the Holy Spirit, speaking to one another in psalms and in hymns, spiritual songs, singing and making melodies in your heart to the Lord. I mean, that sounds like an art to me. I don't know about you. That's so much of art I just read to you in the book of Philippians chapter 15, 18 and 19. It says we should not be drunk with wine, but be filled with the Holy Spirit. Now, the filling of the Holy Spirit is going to give you a creativity. When you are filled with your Holy Spirit, then you are endowed with a creativity from heaven. So when you don't have the Holy Spirit, I wonder, how can you be creative? If you feel you are not creative, probably the Holy Spirit is not in you. Because Holy Spirit is very creative. Are you still with me? It says, be filled with the Holy Spirit, speaking one to another in psalms, my Lord, and in hymns and spiritual songs. What are these songs? And in singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord. So you can just wake up in the morning and start to make melody. I don't know about you. Have you ever woke up one day and you just start to hum a song that you have never heard before? It was never sung before, but you start to sing it and you know in your spirit that song was sounding beautiful while you were waking up. Later on, you are just trying to figure it out. Why is that song has gone out of order? You know, but while you were singing it in your spirit, it was like heaven was opening. It's because of the fact that God is giving you the utterance to enter into the windows of heaven, to draw out of creativity of God himself. I pray in this season that you'll be able to draw out from the creativity of heaven, to be able to do things in another level that you have never done before. I say, let that creativity come upon you now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Some of us, we've been trying to do things the way people in the world have been doing it, but we don't know that we cannot do it that way. We have to do it in a better way. We have to present ourselves better. Even when you go to school, students, please present yourself better. When you're at your working place, please present yourself better. There are some clothes you cannot wear anymore to work, believe me. Because presentation is saying more than that which meets the eye. That means that you are showing what future needs to look like by what you are presenting today. And I'm praying to God that as you start to present your future, that the world around you starts to embrace it with you. I said the world around you embrace it with you. In the mighty name of Jesus. There was a man in the book of Exodus chapter 36 verse 5 by the name of Bezalel. I don't know if you've ever heard that name before. Anyone has ever heard Bezalel before? Anyone has ever heard the name Oholiab? Another name, Oholiab. Quite interesting people. They were gifted. The Bible said God gave Moses how to do the things, but the ability and the skillfulness of the things that Moses needs to do, Moses did not have it. My God. Okay, I'm going to say. Verse 1. Exodus 36 verse 1. So Bezalel and Oholiab was skilled person in whom the Lord has put skill and ability to know how to do all the works of the service of the sanctuary and to do the work according to all that the Lord has commanded. And Moses summoned Bezalel and Oholiab and every skilled person in whom the Lord has put skill, everyone whose heart stirred him to volunteer to do the work. Verse 1 and verse 2 of the book of Exodus chapter 36. So God gave Moses a description from heaven for 40 days and 40 nights. God gave Moses instruction. And while God was giving Moses instruction, looking to the face of Moses, talking to him as a friend will talk to his own companion, these two people were not on top of the mountain, but while they were living in their own small little bedroom, they were hearing from heaven a download of whatever Moses is having. You build it. Let me say that again. I think some of us, we don't really hear what I just said. You see, not only Moses heard from God, Bezalel heard from God, Oholiab heard from God. Many are hearing from God, don't even know that they are hearing from God, because of the fact that they are not a pastor. They felt they are not hearing from God. Because of the fact that you are not a bishop, you feel you are not hearing from God. Whereas there are some few things we cannot do without you. You are so important that you are the carrier of the idea. And you are the one to bring the idea to manifestation. So when the word of the Lord is being released, you are the one that grabs it and says, aha, I know how to work it out. Who is the Bezalel among us in this place today? The one that can interpret dreams. The one that can bring it to manifestation. The one that has the skill of how to work it. May you receive that skillfulness in the mighty name of Jesus. Not only to hear, but to do. To operate in those things that God is speaking in these last days, my Lord. Because God is speaking in these last days, but few are listening. Because what God is saying in these last days, not everybody can hear. You see, the things that you need to be able to receive, the receptacle that we need in these last days, is more than ear. There are some receptacle is called heart. The Bible says, as God has given them the heart to be able to receive it. There are some things I don't need to speak it. All I need to do is to release it spiritually. And if you have a heart which is receptible, then you are able to receive it without even hearing me say anything. Some of you are looking at me, huh? What did you just say? That means I can be talking with my mouth not moving. I can be speaking and voice is not heard. And yet you knew what I wanted. Praise the Lord. Praise Master Jesus. There are some workers in this vineyard. I don't need to say anything. There are not many. Thank God there are not many, or else we would have been in trouble. I don't say anything. I just have the desire. While I'm having the desire, it's been downloaded on their hearts simultaneously. So they come to me and says, Pastor, we want to do this. I say, okay, go ahead, do it. Because there is no way you can have that idea if it wasn't of God. And the fact that you are telling me is a confirmation that you are the one to do the job. If you think when you tell the pastor, that is when the pastor is going to look for someone who's going to do it. It doesn't work in this ministry like that. The fact that you are telling me we need to do it is a confirmation that you are the candidate. And if you don't do it, you are the lazy one that is not doing it. So now you are in trouble for telling me. You should have shut up your mouth. You will have been saved. The fact that you are going to tell me that, Pastor, we need to do this in the church. Aha! You are the candidate to get the thing done. Pastor, but I cannot do it. Aha! Why did you then tell me? Let it become your own duty to seek the face of God until you find the person that can be able to translate your dream. Arts. God is looking for people in these last days to be able to work signs and wonders. Moses was an incredible man of God. The Bible said, after he had an encounter of the burning bush, you remember the story? At least you did it in the Bible school, or you did it in Sunday classes. After Moses had the burning bush experience, God told him, he says, Moses, I'm going to send you to Egypt to go to Pharaoh and tell him to let my people go. Who has ever heard that before in your whole life? All right. Who has ever read that one before in your whole life? Who never read it, but you know it's somewhere in the Bible? Praise the Lord. Go and tell Pharaoh and tell him, let my people go. You see, as much as I read that portion in the Bible, I read it again last weekend. And I read it again last night. And it was as if I've never read it before. Have you ever read a portion of the Bible and then you read it again and it was like you are reading it for the first time? Please read Bible like that. Please. Let it be new to you again. And while I was reading chapter 3 of the book of Exodus, and I was really amazed how interesting and funny God is. God is funny. Absolutely funny. If you're looking for anyone that is funny, come to God. God is absolutely funny. I mean, one afternoon, you are just doing your thing. And God says, you know what? I'm going to send you to United States of America. Make sure you go there and then, you know, tell... I don't know why you are laughing. Because I'm trying to look for a name. Now we don't know who is who. Which one should we call for now? Now one seat for two people. Praise the Lord. My friend is not ready to leave. We are going to pray for Biden. At least evangelicals are praying for Trump. At least let us have some people on this side to pray for Biden. Hey! I will continue my preaching, but we have to pray for Biden. Holy Spirit. That is a prayer request. Somebody needs to take it up in the spirit. This man was the youngest at the age of 29 when he was being called into that position of parliament. At 29 and at 78. See how long it took for him to come this far, whereby they could call him a president. And when the time came for president, please stand to your feet. We have to pray. Please stand. Please stand. Please stand. Please stand. This prayer is not only for Biden, it's for you. When it is your own time to shine, whoever sits down there, God will remove them by fire, by force. Open your mouth and start to pray. Pray for yourself. Pray for yourself. I say pray. When it's time for you to shine, you waited for this long, you waited for your glory to come, you waited for possibility to move, you waited, you were you are faithful, you are just, you are cautious, you are loyal. But when the time for you come to the limelight, even though you won successfully, somebody is still not conceding. Oh, Jesus. Come on, pray. Pray. God is funny. God has a plan. God definitely has a plan. And the plan of God can never be the plan of man. Never. And God says, throw the rod. Throw your rod on the floor. Like it's the rod that we fight Pharaoh. And the Bible says, and it became snake. Put your hands into your cloth. Bring it out. God says, now I've given you... Okay, let me give you one more weight. In case they don't believe, I'm going to... Yeah, just pour water on the ground. It's going to turn to blood. Okay, with these three signs, you are equipped to go to a civilized world who have perfected witchcraft. Go and tell them they let my people go. Was it the real thing that God did? No. That was just to help him to present himself. Because the fight itself was not in the water, was it? Was not even in the rod. Those ones was so that he will carry himself from the wilderness and go to the civilized world and show up and says, well, God has already started the journey. May God use somebody in this place. I'm praying for a different level of usage. That God is going to use you, that you yourself, you will stand behind. You will know fully well this is not your own ability. And by the time it starts using you, you yourself, you'll be afraid of the God you are serving. Let's stand to our feet and pray. I feel the presence of the Lord so strong. Hallelujah. 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 The things that is about to shift in this last days will change the course of history. History will rewrite its own story. I say history will rewrite its own story. I say history will rewrite its own story. I want you to go ahead and be praying and asking, Lord, Lord, here am I. I'm here in your hands. As you use Moses like a rod in your own hands, Lord, use me as your rod in your hands. Bring down anything which is against your will. Lord, fulfill your glory. Lord, answer your call. Lord, fulfill your mandate. Lord, change my name. Lord, rewrite history. Lord, bring people to the awareness of who you are. The civilized world in which we are living, they have not known you yet. Lord, use me as a candidate to show to this new generation that there is God indeed. People even go to church, don't even believe in God. Lord, use me to show to them. Are you praying? Come on, open your mouth and be praying. Lord, use me to show that there is God in Israel, that there is light in Goshen, that there is life where God exists. Lord, remove every obstacle, anything that would not allow the move of God in this season. Lord, shift them away, roll them away, roll them away. Yes, God, yes, God. Every cobweb that wants to hold an elephant to move is just making a joke. Anything that wants to delay the move of the glory of God, Lord, break them in shatters. Shatter them in pieces. Yes, God. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. That hand, you will not use it to bury your children. That hand, you will not use it to bury your grandchildren. That hand, you will not use it to do evil things. That hand will not be cut out in your life. That hand is going to do great mystery. These hands are going to be for signs and for wonders. Those hands are going to heal the sick. I say that hands are going to raise up the dead. I say that hand is going to do wonderful things. I say that hand is going to turn things around.
I say that hands is going to rewrite history. I say these hands, as you lay it on yourself right now, it will bring a renewal upon your destiny. Lay that hands upon your head. Lay it on your head. And prophesy in the next 1 minute the great thing that you're expecting God to do in your life. Go ahead. Go ahead. Say things like, I am the head, I'm not the tail, I'm above, I'm not beneath. Grace. Grace, greater grace, attend to me. I will not be stopped. I will not be delayed. I will not be destroyed. I am covered in the blood of Jesus. It is well with me and my family. Another 30 seconds. Please go ahead and prophesy. Yes, God. Yes, God. Rita liebo suko yede. Ah! You shall get to your destination. Aye, we will not lose you in 2020. We will not lose you in 2021. Whatever you have not been able to accomplish between now and December the 31st, God will surprise you. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Please put those hands together for Jesus. Come on. Put those hands together for Jesus.
Wow, what an incredible service. Thank you so much for watching. If this has blessed you, then join our BOCC family. It's just one click away. Wherever you are, grab your family and let's make this an every week situation. And moreover, share this and bless someone around you. Feel free to visit our BOCC website and social media platforms. Thanks again, and I wish you a beautiful week.